group, because this is prophecy.
Yes.
This is not law. He's prophesying to them, telling them, but this is God, from the mouth of God. Yes, sir. So, go ahead. No one else had anything? Well, don't go to nothing.
Okay. No, I'm just reading the word.
That which they offer, everything that they offer, is what?
Unclean.
So here's some of the manifestations. Ezra 4. Let's see if we look at Ezra 4. Fourth chapter, the first five verses.
Ezra
in the Bible?
Yeah.
Yes.
Second Chronicles. I think that's Ezra.
Oops. And you're walking with the Lord, you think you got it going on, and here's something that'll throw you out of favor. See here. Now when the adversaries of Judah and Benjamin heard that the children of the captivity build a temple unto the Lord God of Israel. Then they came to Zerubbabel and to the chief of the fathers and said unto them, let us build with you, for we seek your God as you do, and we do sacrifice unto him since the days of Esarhaddon, king of Ashur.
Assyria.
Huh?
Assyria.
Ashur. Which brought us up here. But Zerubbabel and Joshua and the rest of the chief of the children of Israel said, our fathers and children said unto them, ye have nothing to do with us to build a house unto our God, for we ourselves together will build unto the Lord God of Israel, king, as the king said. Anybody see any problems with anything so far? Let's go into verse 4. What happened?
Then the people of the land weakened the hands of the people of Judah. Building.
Now you see a problem? Mm-hmm. The problem is that God says you're walking with me in faith and obedience, and you let the enemy do what? Weaken you. Mm-hmm. That would be a problem with God. Said, whose fault was that? That I let them, my adversaries, weaken me. They overcame me. They beat me. They hindered my adversaries. The effect of them weakened me. Whose fault is that? Yours or God's? Man, we just have to go in here and we'll get the right answer. Right answer? Your fault.
Yeah, absolutely.
Your fault. My neighbor stopped me from going to church today. Stopped me from worshiping. Stopped me from... They have another project going on at the job. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Something happened. Circumstances, all of this, I call them excuses. Something happened today. It rained 16 drops today, so I'll stay in. So I don't want to get my Armani wet and all that. So I'm saying. Something else stopped you from walking with God and following His word. And you said that you blamed something else. Oh, you blamed something. Whose fault? God. How does God feel about that? He don't like that. Why are you weak? Your enemies shouldn't stop you. Look at verse 24 of Ezra here. What does it say again? Yeah, let's see here.
Ezra 4:24.
Yeah, what does it say?
Then ceased the work of the house of God, which is at Jerusalem. And it ceased until the second year of the reign of Darius.
So we didn't stop coming, just stop going to church. Just step in. Cousins, family, and everybody else, contrary to the word of God, they start coming over having big necks on Father's Day, on church day, first Sunday, second, whatever it is. I'm not going to church because something else is going on. Somebody has shown me something. Just whatever it is that makes you a weak Christian, God says, whose fault is that? Just consider your ways. Now the blessings have stopped. Stop going. Consider your ways. Now we hold on to the scripture, Philippians 4:19. Can anybody say that to me? Philippians 4:19. But I look at it.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Alright. This is kind of, you know, one time. Which is 419. Psalms 23:3, anybody know that? The third verse of the 23rd division of Psalms. I want to tell you.
Make it mean to lie down in green pastures.
Makes it mean to do what?
Lie down in green pastures.
Which is saying that he does what? He takes care of me. He provides for me. So Philippians 4:19 would have to say something like what? My God
shall supply all my needs according to his riches.
Does it say that?
Yeah.
So for them, so here you have to. Opposition is coming up against you, and we're talking about an offside to make the positive confession and see what the word says, because the opposition is telling you something different. The economy is against you. This and that. You got to stay at work and work all day. You don't have time to go take off time to go to Bible. You got to keep working and stay on the job, that overtime, and all this and all that. And the word says you got to come against that that's contrary to the word by something by saying, my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. You have to be able to come up against that. Because the devil is throwing and coming at you. The Bible says he as a roaring lion. He's coming after you. Just like he did Jesus in the wilderness. And Jesus had to do what? Throw the word back on him. But if you don't throw the word back on the devil and you take what he's got to say, he's weakened you. God's going to say, consider your ways. It ain't me, it's you. Okay, tough lesson, isn't it?
Right, anyway.
All right. Haggai 1, 1 through 5. Did we ever read that? Haggai, the first chapter. Hands going. We're accelerating the pace. Come on, read that real quick. Real quick. They got 1 through 5.
In the second year of Darius the king, in the sixth month, in the first day of the month, came the word of Jehovah by Haggai the prophet, and Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and to Joshua, the son of Jehozadak, the high priest, saying, thus speaketh Jehovah of hosts, saying, this people say, it is not the time for us to come.
The time is not come. Go ahead. The time that the Lord's house should be built. Is that what your version is saying, Jim?
You know what? It doesn't, but this claims it's the King James Version.
Yeah, that's not King James. Then came the word of the Lord by Haggai the prophet, saying, it is time for you, O you, to dwell in your chosen houses. In this house lie at waste. Is it time for you, O you, to dwell in your chiseled houses, and this house lie at waste? Now, therefore, thus said the Lord of hosts, do what?
Consider your ways.
So that's okay. Now, this is what this is. The foundation of this lesson is consider your ways. Now, if we read verse 15 of our lesson, this is Haggai has laid it out. He says, now I pray you consider from this day and upward. From before a stone was laid upon a stone in the temple of the Lord. So he is saying, now that you are getting in faith, God says, I mean faith in total obedience to his word. He says, now from the day, there's an author that says something like this, the day you turn your life around. He says, you should be able to journal that. The day you turn your life around. How many remember the day you turned your life? What?
Is it right there?
Oh, right there, okay. So the day you turn your life around. This is what God is telling them. Before another stone hit the foundation, remember, before I laid this stone, this was the day that I turned my life around. You could be in church. Complete attendance and the whole nine yards. And then you say, this is the day that I really got right with God. You've been on the church world for 50 years and still not be right with God. And you say, this is the day that I turned my life around on God. So this is what he's saying. The day that you can, that you knew that you got right with me and you turned it around, he says, now start counting the blessings. That's what he says. Consider this side of the ledger. When you started turning your life around, you can start counting your blessings. That's what he's saying to them now.
Watch.
Since those days were then, when he was said, one came to a heap of 20 measures, there were but 10. In other words, he says, you went out to do 20, and you only profit netted 10. You're losing half of everything you do when you're not walking with me. I said, you went out and got to do 20, and you thought you had 20, and you got home, and you only had 10. I thought I made $20 a day, no, you only make 10. That's when you're not walking in faith and complete obedience, okay? Then he says, when one came to the press fat for to draw out 50 vessels out of the press, there were but what?
20.
I smote you with blastings and with mildew and with hail and all the labors of your hands. God says, I was working against you when you wasn't with me. Yet you turned not to who? Me, said the Lord. I was with you. How many have been there? Man, you putting all this effort for it, it ain't coming out right. What in the world is going on? Well, in the world, I know I'm doing the right deal, the right steps. I'm following the program, doing everything the way it's supposed to turn out, but it just ain't turning out right. I should profit more than this. Huh? Some people say, I should make so much money per day. Well, Curtis, how much money you got to make a day to make it? You ain't gonna tell us. You know, we got to hit a certain amount of money every day to work that, make that day, that week, that month, that year work out for you. If you're averaging below that, what happened this year? So here God says, I was just working against you. Now he says, again, verse 18, do what?
Consider now.
This day and what? So consider it now going forward. Even from the day that the foundation of the lordship was laid, consider it. Is the seed yet in the barn? Yea, as yet the vine, and the fig tree, and the pomegranate, and the olive tree had not brought forth. From this day, he says, what?
I'm sure
blessing. Because they, in that time frame, they got in favor. They got in obedience, faith, and sanctification. God just won't, you just got to be in holiness, faith and obedience, and things will work for you. But if you got it out of order, I go to church, I show up every day, I get tithes and offerings, but I don't live a sanctified life. So, sisters and knees, I'm going to challenge you here. What can we do about that in the New Testament side of the house? God says, I want to marry that woman, but she ain't saved. She ain't filled up. She ain't nothing. She ain't nothing. She's just world, but she sure is fine.
What can you do? Your witness will get her saved.
I got a room with my buddy. He goes to the ball games, all this and all that. Now, I'm saved. I'll make the evening sanctified just by being with him. Yeah. He's sitting there, and while both of us at the ball game, what's the beverages they serve at the ball game? Kool-Aid or Bud?
Bud Light.
He's going to get him a Bud Light. Sit next to me and choke down the Bud Light. Now, I'm the safe person there, so that's going to bring some light. Will that bring some light?
Just by sitting with him, no. You got to do something. You have to do something, say something. But not just
slick.
Sitting there.
Like, come on over to my house and we'll work in the garden and everything. He's chucking down a Bud Light, smoking a cool or whatever. Like I said, whatever. And does that make the situation? I mean, hey, are we saved? I mean, I'm the saved one here. Like we say, that stuff will jump off on you.
Stand your ground, though,
brother. You have to
stand
around them?
You have to stand your ground. I still say that.
You have to
stand your ground. It depends on how strong or weak the individual is. Every situation is different.
Do you buy that? It's true.
Well, I'm going to agree with both of you. I'm going to be a politician this morning.
Let's look at this priest here.
Okay.
Priest, he did everything. He prepared himself for the temple ceremonies.
Right.
I mean, he was everything. Skirt, everything. And it says, now on his way to God's presence, mm-hmm. if he touch any of that other stuff, is he clean? Is he unclean?
Unclean.
So, even the New Testament saint, I think the scripture says something about separate yourself and come out from among them. Keeping company and then friendship with the world is
imitate with God.
Whoa. So we, I think the cards are stacked against us.
Yes.
They're good friends. They're good friends. What is a good friend? What is a neighbor? What's the extent of this? I got a good friend. I have a neighbor. What does it take to get them saved? How much of me do I have to give over to them?
You just share the word.
Jesus said, forgive them.
But he says, in my who do that?
Brother.
It's my brother. Somebody say he do that. The brother really slapped me upside the head. 69 times a day.
Sister Denise was saying that you were saying it depends on the person.
But how far do you want to go with that person?
Sister Denise was saying, I said I'm going to be a politician this morning. She was saying that it depends on the person and how far you want to go. But now, the example you gave about your buddy going in there and the bud and all, if you continue to be with him, maybe if you just continue to be with him, he's going to most likely influence you. But now, just on a one-time basis, and you find yourself in the presence of someone, just one-time basis, and they are partaking of doing something, then it behooves the one that's saved to withdraw themselves from that. If they are not able to, to withdraw from their presence. But if you keep going, you're going to be influenced by that. You know, there is an old saying in the world that says, birds of a feather flock together. Yeah. Somebody's disagreeing with me over there.
There are some cases where you need to doing business, but you can't let their life influence you.
Right.
You have to be an influence on them.
Yeah.
If you can see where you're influencing that person, don't give up on it.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I agree with that.
If you can feel that them knowing you, then you need to get away from it.
Well, I agree.
And you said that if you feel that they are drawing you.
Yes.
Did Eve feel that the devil was drawing her? Winning her?
It's not indicated in the word.
So can you tell that you have been enticed?
No. Not always.
Not always.
And that's why I said
are you sensitive to what?
Eve didn't know.
To the Holy Ghost.
Yes, definitely.
The Holy Ghost tell you he's enticing you.
I'll tell you a secret. Brother Sonny, when we met, and I know I'm getting off.
Uh-huh.
When we met, he knew that I was saved,
uh-huh.
and I was a baby Christian, knowing the Holy Ghost. He knew I didn't mean business.
Uh-huh.
Yes, he confessed that he was Lord, but when we got saved, guess what? He didn't want to go to church.
Uh-huh.
So you know what? I prayed and prayed, and I said, look here, man.
Wait a minute. Were you all married then?
We were married.
Okay.
We were married. I said, you can sit if you want to, but I'm not going to help a nomad. Ask him today, that's what I told him.
Okay. And I think you're telling us that.
It depends, Brother Williams, on how strong the individual, how determined they are. I was determined that I wasn't going to let no man, and I meant that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Right, what was that? Okay, let's just hear what you say.
I'm thinking. I'm just thinking about what she said. You know, it gets back to what she said, and I think, Brother Buehler, depend on how strong you are. Most people are not, thank God for Sister Denise, but most people are not, don't have that. And not even Eve had it, because she succumbed to it. Most people don't have it, because you, the devices of the enemy are cunning, and most people don't see it. It slips up on them, and they succumb. Yeah, so the best thing to do is, if you know,
he told us to be set apart for a reason.
That's right. Yeah,
set apart.
And I say, don't dialogue with the devil, because see, if Eve had, the devil came and he presented something to her. If she had resisted him then it would be totally different today. Yeah. Yeah. But she began a dialogue with him, and who won? Yeah. We know who won.
Who affected who?
Yeah.
And the example was staying set apart, and it kind of reminds me of what Sister Denise said. Jessica and Martha was saying that.
I was thinking about that.
Jessica. Yeah. Well, first of all, Jessica told him, you're not saved. I can't mm-hmm. God, I'm going to have to just forget about me. There's no way.
Right.
But she still was open to answer his phone calls and answer all his questions and stuff. Mm-hmm. Now, she was wise in directing him to pass the kill into you. Mm-hmm. For answers and stuff like that, but she didn't close the door to where, okay, you're not saying I can't help you at all.
Yeah, I remember hearing that testimony. That is right. And we had a friend like that too. One of us. Yeah, we gotta go. Yeah, good lesson.
That's my purpose, is to stir you up.
Good lesson.
There are cases where there are people in the world that believe in Christ, but they don't live for
that's what that's what we're coming from.
And what they do, and they know that you are a Christian. Mm-hmm. They'll try to get their strength from you.
Yeah.
And I know a guy that we used to run together when I was out in the world.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, mm-hmm. and he tells me now he was afraid of me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But he have a problem with anything that's not mm-hmm. cause that's not concerning the world life. But he needs some spiritual guidance.
He'll
follow
you.
Me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And he said, well, I said, why you always call you? Because I know you're going to tell me the truth. The lifestyle that you live in front of him.
No, that's,
you
that is right.
Life today, you maintain what you believe in.
Yeah.
Eventually, they'll start their life and change.
See, you're a strong person, Brother Buehler. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what we were saying, that mm-hmm. strong people can do that.
Yeah.
You know, but if you don't have that strength of character mm-hmm. to be able to stand, mm-hmm. then you need to remove yourself from mm-hmm. the situation.
And if you're not doing the things that make you strong, like staying engaged in the Word.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. You get, there you go.
I would take
excellent lesson. That's a very good lesson.